Music scene in color. Featuring the best-selling records in the country, as selected and charted by the editors of Billboard, the weekly record and music industry magazine. Tonight, our guests are Tony Bennett, the Grassroots, Emmett Kelly, Buffy St. Marie, Stevie Wonder, the star of music scene, David Steinberg, and our special guest host, Steve Allen.
You're right. I think you're right. I don't know. But I think a lot of guys are changing nowadays. Take our team, for instance. We have a lot of young guys on the team, and they have a tendency to dress a little different. After a ball game, they come in and they take a shower, and I think they want to smell great. And I like to smell great myself, but I want something that smells good and lasts long, so I use Brute.
American men have come to their senses about a lot of things, and Brute is part of it. Brute by Fabergé.
You can't give a woman too much of the real thing, like real perfume, not just cologne, real perfume. Made, bottled, sealed in France by Fabergé in five great fragrances: Tigris, Aphrodisia, Woodyou, Flambeau, Kiku. Real perfume by Fabergé. 2 ounces, $25. After all, you can't give her too much of the real thing.
And now the star of music scene, David Steinberg.
Good evening and welcome to Music Scene. After the peace march a couple of weeks ago, Attorney General Mitchell's wife was quoted as saying, "I don't think the average American realized how desperate it is when a group of demonstrators, not peaceful demonstrators, but the very liberal communists, move into Washington." It was the phrase "liberal communists" that caught the attention of the nitpickers. But the Attorney General jumped right in and cleared everything up. He explained, quote, "The dialogue got confused. It came out liberal communists instead of violence-prone radicals." Now, I certainly understand somebody making a slip like that. It's just very natural. As a matter of fact, this morning I went into a restaurant and I said, "Your money or your life." But what I meant to say was, "Two eggs easy, hold the potatoes." Our special guest, Steve Allen, will be here in a moment, right after this important message from the grassroots. And that message is, heaven knows. The grassroots.
I love you.
Steve Allen is a musician, a composer, an author, an actor, a comedian, and a television personality. He has been successful in all of these endeavors, with, of course, one notable exception. And as the first host of The Tonight Show, he changed a nation's viewing habits. And much the same can be said of me. Since I've been doing this show, the nation has stopped watching on Monday nights. And it is my great pleasure to welcome a genuine Renaissance man, the man who made The Tonight Show what it is today, the Johnny Carson Show. Steve Allen. Welcome, Steve. Nice to have you on the show after you had me on your show. Nice to be able to repay that favor.
Well, thank you very much, David. It's a pleasure to be here in Cancellation Corner.
Steve, I didn't really mean what I said. It wasn't nice being on your show. But I felt, you know, millions of viewers watching, I should say that to you.
That's true. Well, perhaps I should apologize for my little sadistic thrust there, but that is typical of a lot of modern humor, particularly
it
this
is.
MC and guest banter, you know?
Yes. Well, what usually happens is it gets very cute, you know? It gets very much like you're a good man, Charlie Brown.
Yes. One-upmanship, or it's kind of a game anymore.
Yes, it is. It's very much like a game.
Yes.
You know, why don't we not... I mean, we know each other. We just had dinner last night, didn't we?
I know I did. I don't know where you were.
Well, rather...
Has the game started yet?
I think we... You blew a point, you know. Let's bring a referee out and let's just mark our wit.
Oh, a real game?
Yeah, a real game. A referee. Dick Shaw is a referee. Hi, Dick. This is Steve Allen.
How do you do, Ref?
Steve, nice to see you.
Nice to be seen.
Well, now, that's gonna mark our point.
Okay.
Okay, so whoever is up on the other person, Dick will mark it as the referee.
Fair enough. We start all over again now?
Yeah,
we'll start. Coming in?
Yeah, you walk in right from the beginning.
Okay.
Hi, Steve. It's a pleasure to have you on the show.
Thank you, David. It's a pleasure to be had.
Mark to Steve Allen.
Thank you very much.
That was really good. You came right in there and you got a laugh immediately on the cheap line.
I don't happen to think that was
David.
You guess that point?
Yep.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry. I don't think that was a cheap laugh.
Steinberg.
What?
Poor judgment.
I think good judgment on the ref's part, too.
Yeah. By the way, David, when I was coming into the theater a little while ago, I met your fan outside.
Okay. That's very good.
Yeah.
That was good.
Yeah, he's a nice fellow, your fan. He was with his keeper.
2 points for Allen.
Just mark it. Don't enjoy it, will you?
Sorry.
Steve?
Yes.
How's your wife?
Famous.
Allen.
Thank you.
Clever.
Yes.
Famous and clever.
Famous and clever. How is yours?
I don't have a wife.
Steinberg.
Let's see. Do you read?
Well, no, not too much.
I read incessantly.
You see, I don't have the time because I'm always on the phone with Kurt Vonnegut, John Updike, and Norm Mailer.
Allen.
Well, let's do that again. I'm always on the phone with John Updike, Norm Mailer, and Kurt Vonnegut.
Allen. Name dropping.
Oh. But it's only 1 point.
Yeah, right.
The instant replay doesn't count as well.
Let me ask you this, David. Have you read The Godfather?
Oh, yes. As a matter of fact, I couldn't put it down.
I could.
Allen.
Have you read The Love Machine?
Who wrote it?
Steinberg.
I'll try another tack here. Knock, knock.
Come in.
Green point.
You know, Steve, when I was a kid, you know, I used to walk around the house in my Dr. Denton.
Mm-hmm.
I used to think that you were easily the wittiest man that I knew.
Steinberg.
You were a kid.
Yes, I was 4 years old.
Steinberg.
And stupid.
No taste at all.
So the truth is, I never dreamed that I'd be here on my own show really talking to you, because as you know, I am a huge fan of yours.
Well, thank you. You're not so huge, but... But it's nice that you, you know, got this chance on your own show. It's too bad that you blew it with a show that's going off the air.
Alan, that game, set, and match.
We're game, set. Wait a sec. I didn't even get a chance to do anything. The game is just starting now. What do you mean that's tough, kid? Ask me something on the Bible. Just suggest one sermon. Don't keep that tape running. And I don't want anyone to turn their zips or their tubes or whatever you do when something goes amiss. I'd like to display a little intelligence since I feel I've been had. And I'm working now without any cards. This is a totally spontaneous moment. A moment in which I'm just going to show wit and intelligence to the millions of viewers at home. William Blake once said, rather smother a child in the cradle than stifle a creative desire. Didn't think it would get a laugh.
You're getting older now. Maybe you enjoy dating, doing things with friends. And maybe right now you're broken out with acne pimples. Your skin just isn't the way you'd like it to be. So you wash your face with soap and water. Really well. The way you know you should. And then today, you use Stridex medicated pads. Stridex begins where soap and water leave off. Deep cleans the dirt and oil soap and water leave behind. You see it on the pad. What you don't see is the invisible medication Stridex leaves behind. Medication that works all day to help heal, to help make your skin just the way you'd like it to be. Stridex medicated pads. When your skin isn't just the way you'd like it to be.
Do you know what it's like to be in love? Going steady. Being pinned. Starting to collect things. Getting a Lane sweetheart chest. The ring. Then the shower. And stashing things away in your Cedar's sweetheart chest. And the wedding. Then using your Lane sweetheart chest as your first piece of furniture. For people in love, Lane makes 112 kinds of sweetheart chests. All styles, all moods, even a deacon's bench. Lane gives you a terrific choice in sweetheart chests. And almost every other kind of furniture you'll need to live happily ever after.
For your nearest Lane store, see the November 29th issue of TV Guide.
The phrase, I've got to be me, is, as we all know, a rough translation of the famous Roman saying, ego me, ego, ego sum. A philosophical discovery attributed to the ancient Roman thinker Epicurus. The ancient Roman glutton as well. Unfortunately, cannot be with us here tonight. This is an introduction to Tony Bennett, Steve. I just haven't turned away from you. It might look a little bizarre.
Quite all right.
I've Got to Be Me as a handy guide to life, later discovered by such people as Dr. Jekyll, Charlie McCarthy, Strom Thurmond, and now Tony Bennett. And we're very proud to have him sing the title song from his album, I've Got to Be Me. Mr. Tony Bennett.
Whether I'm right or whether I'm wrong, whether I find a place in this world or never belong, I've gotta be me. I've gotta be me. What else can I be but what I am? I want to not merely survive, And I won't give up this dream of life that keeps me alive. I've gotta be me. I've gotta be me. This dream that I see makes me what I am. That faraway prize, that world of success, is waiting for me if I heed the call. Well, I won't settle down or settle for less. As long as there's a half a chance that I can have it all, I'll go it alone. That's how it must be. I can't be right for somebody else if I'm not right for me. Well, I've got to be free. I've got to be free. Daring to try to do it or die. I've got to
somebody who absolutely ought to be her. The very talented Buffy St. Marie.
Have you ever thought of what happens when you smoke a cigarette? We have.
This is B. Mitchell Reed, and stay tuned for more of Music Scene.
Let him see through your blush with new Cellophane's Blush Colors by Yardley. Blushes in see-through color. Transparent, shiny. Like cellophane. Never dull. Sheer, alight. New Yardley Cellophane's blushes that let him see through to you.
Now Glimmerick by Yardley. A watercolor eyeshadow to create eye moods, not just shadows. Glimmerick plus one drop for light-up color. Eyes full of life. Glimmerick plus two drops for soft halos, innocent eyes of love. Glimmerick plus three for melting London look eyes. New Glimmerick plus one, two or three drops for any eye mood you want. By Yardley, of course.
One of Steve Allen's better known comedy creations is The Question Man. Since there are so many questions without answers in the world, The Question Man postulates that there must be an equal number of answers without questions. The Question Man attempts to provide questions for these answers.
Good for him.
For example, if I were to say, the answer is the great Karnak, the question would be, who's stealing the Question Man's act? Ladies and gentlemen, a proud moment in my life. The Question Man.
Hey! Hey, too. Hello, young fella.
Oh, welcome, Question Man. I've wanted to meet you for so many years.
Well, go ahead. I'm meetable.
You certainly are.
I can be had.
Should I just go right ahead into a question or an answer, rather?
You can go right ahead into your dressing room if you want. Whatever you feel like doing, I'm at your service.
Now, these are very tricky answers.
Good.
For which we hope you will find the questions. Do you feel up to it tonight?
No. No, but game trooper that I am, I will persist.
You're a game trooper, aren't you?
I used to work up in Oregon as a game trooper.
Well, I'll play the fool.
What key is it in? I don't know. Bring me my zither and we'll do a duet on the pool.
Here we go. No, don't be sorry. Buy me something. The answer is, Mr. Question Man.
Yes.
Blood, sweat, and tears.
Blood, sweat, and tears. The question is, name three things that Arthur Godfrey's detergent will remove.
See how it works out? Yes, I do. All right, now, no cheating on this one.
All right.
The answer is, my cup runneth over.
That is rubbish. My cup runneth over. Let me see. The question is, how did all that flop get in your thother?
The next answer is...
Yeah, not a moment too soon.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Ring of bright water.
Ring of bright water. That's a toughie.
Yes, it is.
Ring of bright water. The question is, what do you see around the bathtub after Doris Day takes a bath? Is it all right to say that? I don't know.
You'll say anything, won't you, Question Man?
Yeah, anything for a laugh, and that's why it's doubly painful when I don't get it.
Well, I'll just move into the next answer.
Good.
He discovered it. The answer is...
Yes.
He discovered it when he flew a kite.
Discovered it when he flew a kite. Got it. How did Niles Lishness discover string? He discovered it when he flew a...
I guess.
Get the picture?
I get it even with the explanation.
Good. I was hoping to obscure it a little.
The answer is...
Yes.
The sterile cuckoo.
The sterile cuckoo. The question is, who would you let your oversexed parakeet double date with?
All right. The answer is the home of the brave.
Home of the brave. Question is, what should we make Alcatraz?
The home of the brave. We should make Alcatraz.
We should make it, yes. Little social comment.
No, I find that that works.
Yes.
Mad Hatter, White Rabbit, Cheshire Cat, Dormouse, and the Queen of Hearts.
Wow, that's a mouthful. Mad Hatter, White Rabbit, Cheshire Cat, Dormouse, and the Queen of Hearts. Got it. The question is, name a lousy poker hand. What kind of a question is that?
Is there any answer to it?
No.
Oh, here's an answer. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to reverse it on us for a second.
That's all right.
Daisy May.
Daisy May, an easy one. The question is, do you think Daisy will? That's a two-ding joke. We really, for those of you who don't know, we do that when material gets on the program that's a little questionable.
Mm-hmm. A lot of us don't care, Steve. The answer is...
Yes.
Spiro Agnew.
No, it isn't. Never in a million years.
Sorry, I brought it up. No. You're very wise for a question man.
Well, when you've been around as long as I have, it won't do you a darn bit of good.
Here's another answer.
Yes.
Yester me, yester you, yesterday.
Now, you have to concentrate on this one.
Yester me, yester you, and yesterday.
The question is, if the two of us and Dennis Day went out on the town and we asked the same question of the hat check girl at the Club Pasties, what would she say? She'd say, yes to me, yes to you, and yesterday, and the four of us would have a heck of a time. An old gesture of camaraderie.
Yes. Well, the question is, what's number 7 on the Billboard charts? The answer is, yes to me, yes to you, yesterday. And here's Stevie Wonder to sing it today. Stevie Wonder.
What happened to the world we knew when we were dreaming, scheming wild the time away? Yester-me, yester-you, yesterday. Yeah. Where did it go? That yester glow. When we could feel the wheel of life turn our way. Yester me, yester you, yesterday. I have
cornflakes, you get more of the marvelous things in store for you in corn. You get more of the marvelous richness, more of the marvelous flavor, more of the marvelous nourishment of corn to savor.
You get more going for you with Kellogg's Corn Flakes. More good corn taste, morning freshness, wake up Christmas.
More of the marvelous foreness of corn.
You know, chocolate's the world's favorite flavor. And now Kellogg's has taken rich chocolate and put it into America's favorite toaster pastry, Pop-Tarts. Kellogg's Chocolate Fudge Pop-Tarts and Chocolate Vanilla Cream Pop-Tarts. That makes the largest selection of toaster pastries you'll find anywhere. Some with real fruit filling and some with brown sugar cinnamon. Plus the two new kinds with chocolate. Kellogg's Pop-Tarts, the ones with more.
American Airlines credit, take 87. Come on, Mitch, will you get it right? We're going to have to cancel the elephant thing.
Gee, David, I'll try. Travel arrangements and promotional consideration arranged by the people of American Airlines who want everyone to make themselves at home the American way. How's that, David?
Well, it wasn't great, but we'll have to live with it. There's really no one there. Last night, I was with this girl, and we decided to go out for American food. And I noticed one thing about her. She has one quality that really turns me on. Not once in our entire conversation did she say, "Sorry about that." We've been talking for 1 minute, and I've kind of come on to conversationally with her. We've already decided that Robert Penwarren is a great name for a kid. And now the conversation is coming around to me, and I'm really getting excited. Now, I can't help but notice that while we're talking, she is running her fingers sensuously through my mashed potatoes. I'll picture that for a second. My first thought is, what is she doing? My second thought is, who cares? My third thought is, cancel the Jell-O. My fourth thought is, order more. Mashed potatoes. I mean, that's way ahead of where I thought I'd ever be. In my mind, I quickly run down the complete works of Henry Miller. Miller mentioned mashed potatoes. No, no. Are there mashed potatoes in I Am Curious Yellow? No mashed potatoes. They only go as far as yogurt. Well, so I smile at her. And she smiles back at me enigmatically. But her fingers are still going a mile a minute through those potatoes. I'm very cool and confident in most situations. But now, in my head, I'm saying, I got me a freak. The Jackson State College marching band is parading through my brain, spelling it out, and the crowd is yelling, F-R-E-A. I think I've made my point. But aware of all this, I don't want to spoil anything. So I decide to eat around her hand. And she turns to me and she says, David, this is so embarrassing, but I've lost my contact lens. I said, that's all right. We'll go over to my apartment. We can look. And then it occurs to me. In a flash, it dawns on me. I leave Nirvana and come down, down, down to Scarsdale. Let's be honest.
She dropped her contact lens in my mashed potatoes. And then she turns to me and she says, "Sorry about that." I say, as I'm wont to do in situations like that, "Check, please." Mao Zedong, Leon Trotsky, Fidel Castro, Lenin, Stalin, Karl Marx, Khrushchev, and Che Guevara have one thing in common. And to think that Herbert Philbrick had to come to this. What I was going to say was those eight men had one thing in common. I think we can safely say they were all un-American. What happens when you hire an out-of-work actor? Emmett Kelly, on the other hand, is as American as Tony Bennett. And here they are with a message for Americans in these troubled times, and one that we can all take to heart. Tony Bennett singing "Smile," and Emmett Kelly not.
Smile even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by. If you smile through your fears and sorrow, smile and maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through for you. Light up your face with gladness. Hide every trace of sadness. Although a tear may be ever so near,
I'd like to thank our guests this week, Tony Bennett and Emmett Kelly, The Grassroots, Buffy St. Marie, and Stevie Wonder.
Great group.
And Steve, I'd also like to thank you for being on the show. I've been a fan of yours for years, and you've been the innovator of every kind of comedy that lives.
Well, and some that dies, too. Thank you, David, for saying all those nice things.
That's the truth. Anyway,
you're in receipt of a communication.
This is a, I've just been informed from New York that Ed Sullivan has been possessed of a Dybbuk.
One more for you.
Next week on the music scene, our guests will be Gordon Lightfoot, Charlie Pride, Little Richard, Spirit, and our special guest host will be Lou Rawls.
Incidentally, if I were you, I'd be on the lookout for Spirit.
You want to go off with that, Easter? And in addition, as a special treat, and a lot of you have been asking for this, we will attempt to goad Barbara Streisand into singing one song in tempo. Also, there'd be a man here from the Smithsonian Institute who claims that he can actually tell us what has become of Edmund Purdom. That's the truth. So remember, tomorrow will be the first day of the rest of your life. Well, by the ticking of the old calendar page and the hourglass, the old calendar, it's time once again to say, and ask yourself this. I want to hear you ask yourself this. Why am I talking like you? Do you do that to everyone?
Are you?
No, I wasn't.
I don't know. You might as well. I'm talking like Frank Morgan. Charlie Ruggles or somebody.
Ask yourself this. If Robin Hood were alive today, would he rob from the poor and give to the space program? That's it for tonight. Pass your knowledge on to a less fortunate. Don't go into the park after dark. And remember, give, write, read, and wire some candy to a dentist. And remember, and this is interesting, we're just 14 years from 1984. Say something nice to an elephant, he'll never forget it.
That's dumb.
I did. Remember, a tree gave its life so the Reader's Digest might live. Come on, Steve, let's get out of this place.
Why?
It gives me the willies.